Health centers have been part of the community from the start. They allow patients easy access to doctors. They can also learn about new medical resources. We take a closer look at how it all started in San Ysidro. The San Ysidro Health Center started out with humble beginnings in this two-bedroom casita in 1969. A grassroots movement by a group of women who saw the need for medical and dental care in their community. At the time, San Ysidro had a population of 7,000 residents and only one family doctor less than part-time covering the entire region near the border. With little English skills, the group of women knew something had to change. They found their way to La Jolla and sought the help of Dr. Ruth Cavell.
In the 60s, there was essentially no health services in San Ysidro. There was one physician who came in part-time into town, so there was really a huge need there, and San Ysidro was really being neglected.
Cavell also recognized the need in the South County. Because of her experience establishing community clinics across the country, Cavell would help the women start the San Ysidro Health Center 40 years ago. 85-year-old Carmen Martinez was one of those community activists.
Pero había una gran necesidad de que hubiera médicos especialistas, porque había no más una gripa.
Most of the founding mothers, as they are fondly called, are gone, but their legacy lives on, transcending generations.
There wasn't a medical or a dental clinic. The closest doctor was in Hillcrest near the University Hospital. So for many of the, almost all the residents of San Ysidro, there was no access to medical or dental care. So it was their vision that made it happen. They didn't have a grant from the federal government. They didn't have a PhD helping them plan it.
I do recommend that you come back in about a month to get your blood drawn just to make sure that the medication isn't affecting your liver.
Doing the right thing, Dr. Raul Trejo has come full circle, getting his immunization shots to now treating patients at the San Ysidro Health Center. He knew there was still a great need for more qualified doctors in the South County. Trejo would make it a personal mission, graduate from Harvard Medical School, and return to the center as a resident a few years ago.
Well, it's different because the residents are exposed to an underserved, vulnerable population. And I think that provides great opportunities to learn how to effectively care for these patients. A lot of these patients aren't English speaking, and many of them have cultural barriers that interfere with the care.
Carolina Castañón has been working at the health center for the past 30 years. She was also one of the youngest patients, getting her vaccinations during the early years.
Just so amazing seeing from the little house to what it became right now, and actually experience and actually live through being the patient from the little house to actually be employed here and see all this is just overwhelming.
What started out as a vision for the founding mothers turned into a spirit of empowerment for the entire community that is still visible today.
Como esto fue un sueño que se hizo realidad en la clínica, yo me siento muy orgullosa. Nomás de ver ese edificio, de que fue tan chiquito.
I think the founding mothers, as well as the community itself, should take great pride, because this really was a grassroots development. It was not a top-down development, it was grassroots. And without these people becoming activists and somehow they're empowering themselves, none of this would have happened.